Welcome to the video. I've never done a video like this before. I've looked at recently quite a lot of Pink Floyd videos on YouTube, and many people do a ranking, and underneath those rankings many more people put their ranking. So what I've tried to do is amalgamate those into some sort of definitive YouTube ranking list. Therefore, no surprises. It's a pure list of popularity. It's not my list. It's not your list. But this is what I've come up with. Number 15. The Endless River. Not a lot of love for this one. Likewise for number 14. More. Number 13 is amalgamate. Now these three in the bottom three positions, very, very close together. In fact, the last video I looked at, it changed the order completely. I think amalgamate tends to go up and down depending on whether people count just the studio part, as many people do are ranking the studio albums, and the amalgamate studio album is dreadful. If they count the live album, which is terrific, it goes higher up. But anyway, here it is at number 13. Number 12, unequivocally, Momentary Lapse of Reason. Not a lot of love for this one. Many people see it as a David Gilmour solo album. And many people see this one as a Roger Waters solo album. This would be number 11. Some people have this really, really high up. Many people have it really, really low down. I think objectively it is better than this one. It appears in the ranking, but it's not one of my favourites. Number 10, Obscured by Clouds. I've seen a comment that this has got many good songs and not a lot of great ones, which is probably why it's here at number 10. Number 11, That's Also Full of Secrets. It tends to stick, not number 9, sorry. It tends to stick very much in its order. Most people have it right in the middle. In many ways, I just think people do their rankings by sticking Sort of Full Secrets and deciding whether the album that they've got in hand is better or worse than that. So number 8, only just ahead, The Division Bell. Again, lots of people see this as a sort of David Gilmour led Floyd as it's not the best version, and this is where it is. It's not that far behind the Syd Barrett-led Floyd, Piper at the Gates of Dawn. I think if there were more general rock fans rather than Pink Floyd fans doing these lists, I think this would probably be higher up. So into the top 6, and this doesn't change. There are people that have some of these higher, some of them lower, but basically the order remains the same. And unequivocally number 6 is Atom Hammer. Number 5, Metal. Everybody likes Echoes, everybody likes One of These Days. Not so much in the middle, everybody hates Seamus, which is probably why it's number 5. Number 4, and I thought this might be higher, is The Wall. There's quite a lot of love for number 3, which is Animals, and we're going to the top 2, and there are no surprises. Number 2, Wish You Were Here, and number 1, I generally regard it as their best album, is Dark Side of the Moon. So that's the list on YouTube. I say, not my list, not your list. Hope you